So for me, we're trying to build a change capability at the moment. So there's a lot I'm going to take back in terms of how we should be approaching change in the company. I've already invited Mel to come and speak to our transformation director to talk around some of the topics, talk around some of the theory, and understand how we really should be approaching change. So it's really just understanding how we can build this capability in our company and how we can manage change better. We come from quite a strong project company, so we're very good at delivering the task. What we're not so good at sometimes is delivering the behavioural change and the human change that goes alongside that. So it's really trying to broaden people's mind away from just delivering task to actually delivering the change, which will get the overall benefit, and really embed that change so it's sustainable and it can and will remain in the company.
Okay.
We've got a professionalisation of our project management community over the last 3 years. They're all getting AMP trained, so some elements of there are really good. We've just had a new person join our company in the project support office, and we're looking at P3M. So some of the ideas of project, program, portfolio, you know, chime absolutely perfectly with some of the other development maturity of our project management processes. So actually, it's coming at a great time that we're now going to align change management methodology alongside the maturing of our project management portfolio process.
Okay.
Well, for us, it's quite interesting. We had a meeting with our operational forum the other week, and we've had a new CEO join our company recently. So change is very much on the agenda. We've already got a series of teams looking at certain changes. And what I'm keen to do is bring the methodology into those changes to make sure that we're managing them in the correct way. We're not going to swamp people with change all at once. You know, we're actually considering and engaging with people early enough in the process to make those changes sustainable. And we aren't revisiting those changes in, you know, 6-9 months time where the project site is done, the task is done, but actually the change was never really embedded and we never really got the benefits we were looking for. So I'm keen that we set up on the right foot. And some of that may be, you know, a delay to some of the programs we're doing at the moment as we build methodology and as we build capability. But I need other people to understand that and buy into that. Otherwise, I think we'll go down a route where we're having forced change, which will happen quickly, which is what people look for to begin with. But then actually, it's not sustainable. You don't get the benefits you're looking for, and you'll have to repeat the process time and time again. Okay. So there's a lot of theory on the course. So you need to talk about authors, you talk about the year they wrote their theory. And the bit I found really good actually is where you start bringing all the theories together. So we did a great exercise where we used Cotter's steps and then hung some of the theories off that. And it just gives you lots of different ways of looking at the same concept. So, you know, if you're unfreezing or changing and refreezing or whatever elements you're doing, it gives you 5 or 6 different theories that you can look at, say, oh, okay, at this stage I definitely need to be doing, you know, whatever it is, you know, whether it's endings, neutral zone, new beginnings, whatever theory it is, there's lots of elements in there that you can then turn into practical workshops. There are some things there that you do have to go and work out yourself. You know, there's a lot there, but you've got to work out how that's going to work in your organisation. You know, it's very contextual. You know, the thing that will work for one organisation won't necessarily work for another. So there's a lot of interpretation that you need to do to make sure it's going to work in your environment. Pretty good. So I think the engagement across the course is fantastic. You know, the ability of us to work together as teams. You know, there's lots of activities in here, whether it's a team of 2, team of 3, team of 6 on this course sometimes, looking at something, you know, talking about ideas, brainstorming suggestions. We've already talked around setting up a little group afterwards so we can keep in touch a bit and understand what each of us has taken from the training, where we're going next with it, the sort of things we're up to. So just having that peer group's really useful. Sometimes you can feel, certainly in the organisation I'm in at the moment, you can feel that you're one of a small group of people who understand what change actually means and what you're trying to do with change. So having other people, like-minded people,